Worried that old-style Cuba was being overdeveloped, American traveler Chris Allen planned a tropical adventure in the spring of 2014.
Being able to experience Havana and Cuba as it had been for many years was going to be coming to an end, and so I wanted to make sure that I went to see what my friends had seen and said that was worth seeing.
After sightseeing on his first day in Havana, Allen retired to his room in the Hotel Capri on the 14th floor. Within minutes of laying on the bed, he starts losing feeling in his limbs.
That was happening very quickly over the course of minutes, to where it went from the tip of my toes, through my toes, down through the arch of my foot and up to my ankles. And I could feel a little bit in my fingertips, and it was so noticeable, and it happened so quickly that it was all I could focus on, and it really, really frightened me.
The tingling sensation that started in his toes and spread up his body dissipates when Allen gets up to investigate. But when he returns to the bed, it comes back and spreads. Whatever happened to Allen that night, it happened again the next. He left Cuba in a hurry, but the symptoms stayed with him for 6 months as a team of neurologists tried and failed to find a cause for his sudden-onset numbness. Allen agreed to share the details of his Havana visit with the Associated Press on the condition that his image not be used. The AP reviewed more than 30 pages of his medical notes, lab results, travel agency records, and contemporaneous emails. They show that Allen gave the same harrowing account over and over after returning from Cuba, almost 2 years before anything about the attacks on Americans at Hotel Capri and elsewhere were publicly known.
My mind knew that there was something happening to my body, but had no way of knowing why it was happening and how to control it.
Allen's case, if connected, would mean the attacks have not been limited to just the 22 government workers the US says are medically confirmed to be affected. And if a tourist really was hit, it's what US officials have increasingly feared.
I do believe Cuba is responsible. I do believe that. And it's a very unusual attack, as you know, but I do believe Cuba is responsible.
The State Department has taken the extraordinary step of issuing a health travel warning to Cuba, highlighting concerns that attacks had occurred in the same hotels where Americans typically stay. The AP has been contacted by roughly 36 American citizens who believe they may have been affected by the same or related attacks. But while AP has not been able to corroborate other instances, Chris Allen's case stands out. He stayed in the same Havana hotel where the US has confirmed attacks occurred and described sudden onset symptoms that began while in bed but disappeared when he moved to other parts of the room. All factors consistent with accounts given by US government workers who suffered in the health attacks. Tracy Brown, Associated Press.